We are looking at chapter 4, determinants. Properties of determinants. So what are the properties when we are dealing with determinants, rows and columns? Let us see one by one. Property 1 is the value of determinant remains unchanged if the rows and columns are interchanged. That means if this is say a determinant or a matrix which is having a determinant, then if you solve it and you just interchange the rows and columns, that is, if you change the rows into columns and columns into row, that is, make it as transpose. So when you transpose it, means making it row or row to column, column to row, you see that both the results are exactly same. So it follows that this property, if A is a square matrix, then determinant of A shall be equal to determinant of A dash, that is the transpose, and A transpose is the transpose of A. And when we change from row to column, we just write C R, that is changing from column to row, or you can also write row to column like this II, because second row goes to second column like this. Verify property 1 for this one, that is, we are changing row to column. So let us solve this first, and we have been doing or expanding it with row 1. Now let us change, that is, transpose the rows and columns, find out the transpose and find out the result. You see that the result both ways are same. If any two rows of a column are interchanged, then sign of the determinant changes. So if this is what we have, let us see what we get. This is a normal determinant. Now we will be changing this column to this row to this row, third row to the first row, and when we have changed this, this has obviously come on this location. So when we solve it, we see it is equal to minus of the determinant of the previous one. So we can also verify the result by changing any two columns. So when we denote, when we do this, we denote the interchange of rows by ri to rj, this is I and j, or ci to cj. Then we have to verify this property. Let us take this. First of all, try to solve it. As we have already done, this is minus 28. But when we change or interchange rows 2 and 3, so this has come here, this has come here. As you see here, this has come here and this one has come, taken the third row position. So when we solve it, or when we take the determinant, it is equal to 28, which is the negative of minus 28. If any two rows of a determinant are identical, the value of the determinant is 0. So it is quite easy, as we just have known, that if you interchange the identical row of the determinant, then the determinant will not change. So by property 2, this determinant will be equal to minus of determinant, which if you take it here, 2 delta will be equal to 0, so delta will be 0. So this is how you can prove it. We have to evaluate this, as we see here, that this first row and third row, they are exactly same. When we expand it using any row, you'll get 0 only, because R1 and R3, they are identical. If each element of a row of a determinant is multiplied by the constant k, then its value gets multiplied by k. Whole determinant value is multiplied by k. So if this is the determinant you have, and if you multiply it by k, say this k a1, k b1, k c1, then when you solve this, means if you solve this one, and you solve this one, that is with k, you see that the delta is k times the initial delta. Okay, so this is nothing but you can take k out of one row. So this is k into the determinant of the original value. And by this property, we can take out any common factor. As we have just seen, we have taken k out from any row or from any column. And if the corresponding element of any two rows or columns of a determinant they are proportional. That is as good as that two rows are equal, because when you take this k out, this will be ka1, a2, a3, and this row and this row are equal. When two rows are equal, or when any two rows are equal, or two columns are equal, then the result is 0, because they are proportional. Then we have this one. So just evaluate this. The best thing is 102 can be written as 6 into 70, and this is 6 into 3, this is 6 into 6. So we can take this 6 out, this is 6 out. So now you get this, and in this, the first row and the last row, they are first and third row, they are equal. So the determinant will be 0. Next property says, if some or all elements of a row or a column of a determinant are expressed as sum of two or more terms. See, this is a1 plus lambda 1, this is a2 plus lambda 2, and a3 plus lambda 3. So this is actually a sum. So the determinant can be expressed as sum of two or more determinants. Now we can write it as addition of two different determinants. Like, first we'll take this, this and this. Okay. Then we'll take this here. Okay. So you can verify this. Let us solve it. And when we solve it, when we solve this also, we get the same result. We have to show that this is equal to 0. So we can take this a x first, b b y first, c c z, and then this is one determinant we can take. The another we can take this a 2xx, b 2yy, and c 2zz. In this both the case, see, these two rows are similar, so this is 0. And if we take two common here from second row, we get x, y, z. If we take two common, x, y, z, x, y, z. So these two rows also become 0, equal, so it is 0. So 0 plus 0 is 0. Property next is, I'll try to explain it, because it is better understood when you are actually dealing with the determinant. So what this is showing is, you are changing any row with multiplying the another row. Say you're changing Ri with addition of Rj multiplied by some constant term. And you can also do it for the column also. So if to each element of any row or column of a determinant, the equimultiples of corresponding element of other row or other column are added, and the value of determinant remains same. That is, the value of determinant remains same if we apply this or this. That means, if I take this, I want to change this R1. How to change this R1? I want to add R1 with multiplying K to this row 3. So, A1 plus KC1, A1 plus KC2, A3 plus KC3. Now, what we have done is, we have taken this, added with the multiplication of k with this row, and the things remain same. It will not change. If you want to verify, you can just equate it like this, because this is actually equal to two different determinants. And when you take k out, these two becomes equal and this is 0. So, you get the original determinant by itself. If some determinant obtained by doing this and this, then if you are not doing anything, just multiplying some k with this row, say ri with ri, the determinant will get multiplied by k, and this is similar with the column also. So if more than one operation like this is done in one step, you need to take care, because it may give rise to some different sign. Prove that a2a3a, a plus b 3a plus 2b, 6a plus 3b, a plus b is 4a plus 3b plus 2c, 10a plus 6b plus 3c is equal to aq. See, the best thing is, if I multiply this by 2 and subtract, I get 0 here. And if I multiply this by 3 and subtract this row, then we get 0 here. This is what we are going to do. Row 2 will multiply 2 with row 1 and subtract. Again, we will multiply 3 with row 1 and subtract with R3. So R3 means R3 minus 3 R2. R2 means R2 minus 2 R2. We get 2 zeros here. And then you can also do one thing, because right now we can get few more zeros. This is A. So let us multiply this by 3. So you get 3 and you can subtract these two rows. So we have multiplied the row 2 with 3 and subtracted it from R3, you get this. Now you can just expand and you get, when you solve it, you get A into A square, that is A cube. Then without expanding, you have to prove this. So let us add this. X plus Y with Z means R1 plus R2. Change R1 such that you get R1 plus R2. This is X plus Y plus Z, X plus Y plus Z, and similarly here. So now take X plus Y plus Z as common. You get 1 here, 1 here, 1 here. Since two rows are common or they are equal, the result will be 0. Evaluate this. So first, we would like to have maximum zeros. So R2 will change, so that R2 minus R1. R3 will change, R3 minus R1. So you get 0, 0 here. And you can take, say, A minus B, B minus B is here. So you can take B minus A or A minus B or B minus A common. Again, C minus A or A minus C, as one is of them common. So B minus A, C minus A, we have taken common. And again, when we expand it using the first row, we get this as a final result. We have to prove this as 4ABC. So what we'll do here is, we will change the row 1 and subtract row 1 with row 2 and row 3. So you get this some equation so that you can get some 0. Now, when we expand it and just solve it, we'll get 4ABC. This is, you just have to do one row, transformation or change. If X, Y, Z are different, that is, they are not equal, and this is equal to 0, then you have to show that 1 plus X plus Y plus Z equal to 0. So what we can do here is, first of all, we can use the property and you take this determinant first, and then remove this, the next determinant. So we can write it as addition of two determinants. So 1 and 2. Now we can take X, Y, Z common here. So we get X from here, Y from here, Z from here. So 1 plus X, Y, Z. Because this is X. See, this is X. We have taken X. So we get 1, 1, 1 here. We get X, Y, Z here. We get X square, Y square, Z square. But these two are not similar. So we have to rearrange. Means we have to take the columns and rearrange so that we get equal to this. So that we can take this, these two as common. So that we get 1 plus X plus Y, X, Y, Z. So what we have done here is, we have changed the column 3 to column 2 and column 1 to column 3. So when we transform once, it will be minus, and when we transform again, it will be minus of minus, so plus. So there will be no sign change. And here, but in for this, because we have done it twice, so minus minus plus. This is minus minus plus. So now these two becomes equal. So now we can take these two common, and inside this we'll get 1 plus x plus 1 plus x y z. And when we solve this, or you can just expand it, or first you can find out R2 is R2 minus R1, and R3 is R3 minus R1. So you get two zeros here. Now you can either take y minus z, y minus x common, z minus x common, but that would remain, if you take this common, this will remain, and now expand it. When you expand, you get only z minus y. So since y is not equal to x, these three are not equal, so this will not be 0. So 1 plus x plus y plus z has to be 0. This is what we have to prove. We have to show that this is equal to this. So how to solve this? First of all, you have to, because we want this, we have to make something like this. So let us take A common from here. If we take A common from here, it will be 1 by A. We take B common from this second row, 1 by B, 1 plus B by B, and 1 by B. C from third row, so C, 1 by C, 1 by C, and 1 plus C by C. So 1 plus A by 1, we get here. This is 1 by A, 1 by A. You know that when we take ABC, I've showed you how to find it. Now, this, we can add R1, R2, R3, Y. because we need to get this. Okay, we need to get 1 plus a, 1 by a plus 1 by b, 1 by c. So when we add these three, we get this. So when we add, we get what we have wanted. We can take this out, and this will be 1, 1, 1, and we can just do C2 minus C1 and change C3 to C3 minus C1. And now we can just expand. So we get 1 here. And this is nothing but what we intended to have. And when we multiply ABC inside, you get this. You can also try this C1 to C1 minus C2, C3 to C3 minus C2, and then you can apply C1 minus AC3. So this is the second part of the determinants. We'll be taking a few more. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.